Okay, assalamu alaikum. This is one of the bridal suits in the very heavy, thick stonework. Now, I have over time sewn several of these, and you will find full tutorials of the suits scattered here and there. Okay, basically, with this one, I have done a slight bit of a variation to perhaps what I did in the past. And if you want to go ahead and watch some of the slight variations, then I will make this video a slightly lengthy video where I will add all the sewing parts towards the end. So continue watching. I'll just give you a brief description of what the video will entail, and that will prepare you for if you want to go ahead and watch the video. Obviously, one of the reasons why you'd want to watch the video is if you bought a suit like this and if you're going to stitch it, then it would give you ideas and prepare you for what kind of alterations and amendments you can do to make something like this. So these suits are quite common, readily available in lots and lots of shops and bazaars and so on. Price of these suits is generally between 45, 40 to £60, depending, or £65, depending on the quality. This is the slightly lesser quality. There is one that I've done previous to this in a turquoise color, which is of the heavier quality. The price of that is roughly £85. 80 to £85. Okay, with this one, we've done a closed frock, and the slight variation that I did was I took it up from the sides so that when the dress is worn, it's more all rounded effect rather than a droopy effect from the sides. In the past, I've done these where I've left the jacks open, and you can see some of those videos too. Also, when you close these dresses up, sometimes these drooped edges, you can see the raw unselvaged edges from here. One of the other problems that you have with dresses like this is that they do be difficult to overlock and so on. So you can have threads dangling down, and it looks quite horrendous when you've got threads hanging down from this area. So in the video, I've explained how you can go about making this so that your finishing of where you've joined the two layers, it actually is hidden away on the inside. Other slight variations I've shown in this dress is I did actually take this apart up to the point of the waistline, because one of the problems that you have if you're making this for a very slim size, then the problem you will have is on the waistline. If the centerpiece is too wide, then the fitting becomes virtually impossible. So, you will see how to open this up and how to shape it prior to putting the garment back together. Now, one of the problems that with shaping it from here, one of the other problems that often occurs is then it's not wide enough on the under the arm or the bust area. And we did take some of the leftover pieces that we had from the sleeves or from where the armhole cutting came out from, and added them as an extension so that it gives you more room on the bust. Other problems that you encounter with these suits is that there's generally no underlay or under the borders. They're single attached borders, and they don't look very attractive. They are quite rough, and often you do need to pull these apart in order to get a good hanging and also a good finishing. Okay, now one of the problems I've encountered with this is when I've pressed this, numerous stones have come off. I haven't actually got time to stick all those stones back on, so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna parcel them off with the suit, and I will let the sister add them to wherever she wants. Some places are obvious and some places are not so obvious where the stones have come off from, but anywhere they feel, if they feel that they need to add the stones back on, then I will leave it to them to, you just need a bit of dab of glue. Like here is a quite an obvious place, also from here. So there's quite a few that have come off from quite a few places. Obviously, we need time to add them back on and let them dry out. Now that's part of the tutorials I've done on this suit. The other main difference I've done is here I've got a churidar, and there were two churidars that I've made. So I've done a double take on a churidar, and I've included it so that you can watch how I did the initial and then how I went on to do the second portion of it. Churidars are quite common. I've been making churidars online for a very, very long time, so you'll be able to find tutorials on a churidar in numerous places. Basically, with this one, I've explained how you can save maximum amount of fabric so that if you experience problems that, you know, there isn't enough fabric for the lining, then, you know, you can use the same cut as I've used in this churidar making, so that you can go on to cut a churidar and also a full lining. So that's going to be all attached to the end of this video. It's going to be a slightly lengthier video. If you're interested in making something like this with a good fit and a good drop, then by all means keep on watching the video and enjoy and share with other viewers, and leave your comments, and I will hope to see you again for the making of this suit, which is a Mina Hassan replica that I sold last year. So inshallah, I had intentions of making this in a particular style. I did start cutting it and I actually made some mistakes. You can watch the mistakes that I made and how I went on to rectify those mistakes in order to complete the suit. So, you know, it's not all about straightforward sewing. Sometimes things work for the best and they don't always go according to what we plan. But look at the positive side and, you know, try and inspire yourself to, even when you think it's a disaster and it's not going too well, then try and plan to make something good out of a worse situation. So take care, and I will join you with the making of this suit. At the bottom of the hemline of this dress, what I did was slightly curved the edges of the dress so that it doesn't have a dragged down effect, because it's like a A-line and it's got heavy work, and when you've got the border attaching, the kameez lifts from the center and drops from the sides. So by taking a small portion of away from both the sides, what I've done is created like a roundish type of effect. And the way you can tell that is when you stand it up like this, the edges won't droop towards the bottom line. So this is the front side of the gear. I'm going to do the back, and I'll just show you quickly what I did and how I went going about attaching the border to the hemline. Now it does have a few strands here or there. Try to take them away. It is a little bit difficult to sew in regards to having so many beads and so on. I have in the process broken a good number of needles, so be careful. Try and use a needle which is a slightly thicker, maybe a size 16 needle, size 16 or 18 needle. Generally, I tend to use a size 12 or a 14 on a lot of the sewing. Now, the other thing that I've done is when these suits came, they had no attachment on the underside where the bottom of this was exposed, and it didn't really do much for it. So I've added my own piece of fabric at the bottom to give this a good finishing. This is the back. I've done this to both the front and the back. So just a seam. I did initially take all this apart, and I have shaped the dresses also. Now these dresses, unfortunately, they are very difficult to overlock, so I've not bothered overlocking, because hopefully this type of chiffon, these aren't suits that are wearable all the time anyway, so the amount of limited usage that you get out, they should last enough over time. Now again, I've rounded it off here, and what I'm going to do is take the border, attach it all the way on the right side, and then attach it on the wrong side by twisting it and doing the snake-like effect seaming. So once I've attached the borders, I'm going to make sure that the side lines match side to side. Now the other thing that I want to do is when I attach the back border, I want to attach this sort of, if you know what I mean, invisibly. So I want to attach it and then I want to turn this over and attach that and turn it over so that this hemline at the bottom, it becomes invisible inside the seam. So maybe once I've attached this, I'll come back and just show you what I'm going to do with that. So with sewing, sometimes it's depending on the fabric and depending on the type of work that you're sewing, there may be just different applications you may need to apply, and often you have to look at the fabric and judge that. Like in this instance, the beadwork, the neckline is not overly big, it's quite small, so we have to go quite close to the beaded neckline, and in order to do that you have to change the foot on the machine, because otherwise the normal foot, it will sew quite far from the edge and the neckline will become even smaller. So these are circumstances where you have to apply different methods. Also, what I found with this stonework is if your foot is quite a wide foot, and now for some reason I've gone and lost one of my normal sewing foots, this is for I assumed that being a softer touch, this would be easier to sew, but with stonework, a lot of the time what happens is the foot presses against the on the stones, and the delicate fabric georgette, actually the stones tend to tear a hole inside the georgette. So you have to bear all that in mind. Now in those circumstances, what might end up helping is a foot like maybe a narrow foot or a one-sided foot, because it's jumping less on the stones, so it'll be easier to maneuver. So I've changed the foot. Generally I use this for piping and so on. So I'm going to be using that just to, I've attached the neckline and by using this foot, and now I'm going to use the same, I'm going to leave that foot in one place and I'm going to do the back of the neckline. So place your lining underneath and then place the, preferably just pin this into place, because obviously you've got quite a few layers of fabrics and it's difficult, becomes difficult to handle.
How does this
push? So we've got, go and play outside.
How does this push? Adam,
oh,
from
never
the
mind.
Swing and you hurt on,
oh, never
your
mind.
On your switch thing on your off
Daddy.
Thing.
Oh, never mind.
Daddy, I'm hungry.
You're hungry? Okay, I'm coming.
Yeah, and Adam hurt himself.
Okay, it's gonna be pancake. It's gonna be pancake day today.
No, no, the other day on Tuesday.
Pancakes be on Tuesday.
No, the Tuesday.
Shiro's Tuesday.
No, the Tuesday.
Yeah, they were.
I want pancakes.
Right, you're all gonna
I
have to
one
wait.
Pancake.
You're gonna have to leave me for a bit, yeah? So I can finish this neckline and then I'll come and make you pancakes.
Let me
go
to the basket
again
outside.
Asgard will come back.
Nah.
No. Alright, but he doesn't bring me flour. So he brings me flour.
No.
Oh, why have you turned my light off for? Turn the light back on. Turn the light back on, please.
I will.
Can you put the light back on?
Switch.
Oh.
Wow, look at these lights.
Now.
Look at these.
Oh, I see that.
Stop playing about the light, please.
Naya is putting the light.
Naya, you're big. Why are you misbehaving? Look, already it's dark over here. I need a bit more light.
Why are you wearing Naya? Because this is my party room.
Right, so place that. We're going to do the layering of the back neckline. Leave it for the time being, because it's difficult to maneuver and it's difficult to handle because of so much. The weight of it is quite excessive.
Can I look at the camera?
Can you look at the camera? No, you can't look at the camera. Because, look, I'm trying to, today I'm trying to sew, teach people how to sew.
Teach all they know how to sew.
Eh?
But you know how to sew.
Who knows how to sew?
Everyone in the world.
Everyone in the world knows how to sew. No, don't do that. You're going to get your finger trapped. Except your mum. Well, you need to tell your mum to watch the videos.
She does.
So she can learn how to sew. How can we tell people to learn to watch the videos and learn to sew if your mom doesn't? Your mom thinks that she's lucky because she's got me to sew for her. That's nice.
Excuse me.
She knows how to sew.
Yes.
Okay. I will give her a few pairs of clothes to sew for me then.
Like arms.
Like your clothes.
Yeah.
I'll give her your clothes to sew.
You don't have to make me any clothes because I'm going to get some clothes from town.
Okay.
Because, you know, so she found some nice clothes, my size. She said,
when
you
go
home,
please get ready. Very good.
Yes.
Peace and quiet from you at least.
Then that tree. Yes, and then you have to make me a little skirt.
You just said you can buy your clothes from town. So if you can buy your clothes from town, then that means I don't have to sew for you.
Well, you do. Bye. Yes.
Can't win, can you? You just cannot win. Okay, we're just lining the back of the neckline with a bias cut piece of fabric before we got. Now, you know, a weekend we plan that you're gonna do this and you're gonna do that, and then weekends are really booked for the family and the children. I tend to have.
Turn off!
No, you can't turn it off, darling. If you turn it off, I won't be able to see anything. Will I?
You will see me.
I will see you.
Yeah.
I won't be able to see how to sew. And I want to see what I'm sewing.
Turn it off. Will it be really dark?
It will be dark, yeah.
Shall I turn it off?
Not really.
I'm
not finished yet.
Where are you going to?
I've got to do a little bit more yet.
Huh?
I've got to do a little bit more yet.
Where are you going to?
Where am I going? I'm not going anywhere. I'm going to go downstairs to the kitchen to make food for you.
Semia again.
What? You want Semia again? No, we had Semia yesterday. I thought we would make pancakes today. Oh, we met paratas today.
Paratas?
Yeah, I think Dada wants paratas. What do you reckon?
Paratas is spicy food.
Paratas aren't spicy food.
Do you want this?
I will want that, yeah. Yo-yo. It's a spool.
Yeah.
It's called a spool. It's not called a spoon, it's called a spool. Okay? No, it's called a spool. Okay, so what we're gonna do now is we're going to close these two separately. But as promised, what I want to do is we're going to leave the lining part separate. We've attached them on the shoulders and the neckline, but that's all we're going to do. Now we're going to attach the sides of the gummies. So leave the two lines. Like such. That's the two linings. And then both the right sides of the gummies facing each other. We're going to measure this down. And preferably mark it out to your fitting size, because this is one fabric where you do not want to do multi amounts of sewing on. Try and cut down the sewing as much as possible. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take it to the table, I'm going to mark it out, but that's basically what you're matching up. The way I've matched this up, it seems like one is coming out quite a bit longer than the other, and really I need these both to be same size, because I want to attach from here going all the way up to the armhole line. So if this proves to be
the case where one is longer than the other, then now is the time to amend it before I do go on to... No, they're coming out right. It's just my measuring. Okay, but we need to mark out the fitting marks prior to doing this fitting seam. Okay, so the back of the turning over part for the hem is not being turned over. The front one is finished. So I'm going to just place this on top of each other with the right side at the bottom, making sure is the back, and then on the top, facing right sides facing each other, is the right side. Stop it!
Tablet.
No, you can't have my tablet.
Should we both watch on you?
Now it is, like I mentioned, because of such a heavy stonework, and it's virtually impossible to take these, these small stones off. You have to make the machine really jump and just guide it along as best you can. It is quite difficult to sew, is this fabric. So I've already chalk marked out where I want the fitting to go. Naya, can you just go to that room, in Bubba's room, and there's a battery for a camera.
Oh, do you know
room.
We even have
can
one?
Pull?
We have one at my house. I bring it over one day.
Which battery have you got? It's in that drawer where the threads are.
Oh.
It's in that camera, that charger. Can you just take it out and bring it for me, please? Just slide it out. That's one side seamed up all the way. Now we're going to be doing the other side, and again, this side, this time we're going to go downwards.
Out.
Yeah, that's what I wanted. That's what I needed. So this time we're going to go down. No, I need that one. You're going to take the other one and put it on charge. Look, the battery is flashing. So we're going to be sewing upwards, downwards this time, starting from underneath the armhole seam. And again, lots of gibbering and pushing of the machine because of all the beads underneath. As much as the baby come.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm coming. As much as these suits are pretty, they are just such a pain. I'm coming down to see the baby. My grandson, baby Idris, is here. So I'm going to be loving you and leaving you in a bit to go and spend some quality time.
How am I going to take this off?
How are you going to take that off? Well, we will finish this seam off just to guide you on exactly what you're doing. So follow this down all the way to G. Dreaded big bead. that you needed to take off in order to continue.
Hello, Alaikum Salaam. Okay, so just a bit of an explanation before we go ahead and finish off this dress. Basically what I've done is I've done the fitting on the outer side dress portion from the shoulder up to, well, starting from the bottom going upwards on the one side from the hemline, and what you're seeing here is the backdrop from the hemline, which is going to be turned over. Now what I wanted to explain was this is the joining seam on the side, and I wanted to trap this so that when the dress is opened up or when it's worn from the side of the dress, this seam is not, you know, where the joining seam is, it's not visible. So I wanted to sort of hide it away on the inside. So the way I've done that is, that's the front, this is the back. The front I've finished completely with the turning over and seamed over. Now the back one, what we've done is left the back flapping, okay, and this is the side seam. I've closed it up and then I've twisted it around so that will, and I've only closed that up from the first about three four inches. And the whole width of this trim on the border is approximately 6 inches, so it's given us about 3 inches that I've left a space where I can turn this over from. So when we pull this out, the seaming between the two joints, front and the back, is hidden away on the inside of this. So that's really the most important part that I wanted to show you in this. So what I'm going to do now with this opening is I'm going to grab hold of this like this and attach it all the way, you know, and it's going to give me a small, towards the end it's going to become a bit of a tight squeeze, but we're going to do it to as much as we can, and if I can't do it right to the end, I'll do a hand thereby just towards the end. So this dress now is basically all finished from the front side. I'm just going to turn it inside out and just sort of guide you on what I'm going to do with the inside of this. The inside seam, lining seam, is not done. Okay, so that's the lining of the inner dress. This I'm just going to seam up separately, just according to the fitting. So roughly mark it out on the fitting and just do close it off completely, and then once it's closed off, hem the bottom, turn it back inside out, complete the sleeves, and then just attach the sleeves on the round. So this portion of it is lots of videos available. It's a quite an easy way to finish off the garment. So the only difficult part in this now is attaching this hem on the inside so that we can save. Now if you find this hard, too hard, then the easy way for you to be able to finish this off is close off this seam, leaving enough of a turning, and then just turn this on the inside and just do far off hand thereby all the way. If you find it difficult to do, then you know what, that's the alternative that you can use. But if you can do it on the inside, then I would advise you to do it like that.